Hello and welcome to the Center of Excellence training series on TAK. In this tutorial, we will cover how to access and begin using WebTAK as part of the COTAK system. Let's get started. WebTAK is the most simplified version of TAK and can be run in a web browser. WebTAK is a great solution for those who are on Mac OS or simply cannot download the Windows version of TAK, called WinTAK, due to firewall protections or agency digital security procedures. However, a key limitation of WebTAK is that it cannot provide live GPS tracking of your location. Rather, it asks for your location once when you first start it. As a result, WebTAK is best suited for use in dispatch centers, offices, or other situations where your live GPS location does not need to be shared with other first responders. We will cover five main features of WebTAK in this video: self-information, basic orientation, channels, contacts, and base map options. To access WebTAK, navigate using a web browser to ops.cotak.gov. Accept the Terms and Conditions pop-up, and enter the same username and password you use elsewhere in COTAK. A pop-up will ask you to share your location with WebTAK. If you allow this, your location as determined by the internet address of your computer will be automatically captured. Note that this location is rarely as accurate as the GPS coordinates available through other TAK apps. A pop-up menu will then appear allowing you to edit your call sign and other user information. We recommend using the call sign convention, agency acronym, last name, and radio call sign. Next, decide which color your marker will show as on the map. View this table to see which color you should choose. Finally, choose your role based on the table provided. When in doubt, choose the team member option. To the right of the grid coordinates, you can allow your web browser to automatically update your location again by clicking on the Location button. After clicking Save, you should see the main map screen. Click and drag to move the map around. Use the scroll wheel or the plus and minus buttons to zoom in and out. In the bottom left, you will see an icon of a person. Click this icon and then Edit to alter your call sign, team, and role that you previously selected when you logged in. You can also change your reported location here by clicking on the grid coordinates listed next to location, then clicking on the map to update your location, then save. To minimize this screen, you may click on the User Information tab, or you may click and drag the window to become larger or minimized. To see many of the standard TAK options, click the button with three boxes and a plus. This is the launcher function. It allows you to place the menu options wherever you'd like on the display. Most believe it on the left side. Click and drag the edge of the launcher to scale the menu. Within the launcher, you will find several useful tools similar to ATAK and iTAK. If the launcher tool ever takes up your entire screen, you may drag the launcher tab to the left to see the map again. Next, I will cover how to use some of these tools, starting with channels. Select channels from the bottom right. You'll see a list of the channels that are available to your COTAK account. Clicking on the checkbox next to the channel turns it on, which shares your location with all other users on that same channel and enables you to interact. Turning a channel off removes your location and presence from that channel. Each COTAK first responder sees a unique list of channels based on your login. Some of these channels were created by your agency administrator and are only available to members of your public safety organization, while other channels are available to multiple agencies for use in mutual aid. The COTAK team recommends only turning on mutual aid channels when a need for them arises, but refer to your own agency's policies for definitive guidance. It's important to remember that within any TAK platform, changes made regarding your channels carry over to any other TAK apps linked to your COTAK account. Click on the Channels window on the vertical toolbar to minimize it. If you have channels turned on and other users are currently online, you will begin seeing dots appear on your map. Dots show the last reported GPS location of other first responders, which ranges from near real time up to approximately 10 minutes old. A dot with a slash through it indicates that a user is still running the TAK app but has lost GPS reception. These dots with slash marks indicate the last known location of the responder but may be several minutes old. and should be treated with caution as a responder may have moved in the meantime. Any dot, including your own pointer arrow, can be clicked on to receive additional information or tools. When tapping on another user's dot, a wheel of options appears with their call sign and coordinates under it. The specific options in this wheel vary depending on the type of marker, and in this video we will cover the most common configuration. At the 3 o'clock position, you will find the Details menu. This menu will display the call sign and any remarks for the point, the GPS coordinates of the point, the time the marker was last shared with you, and other details. At the 6 o'clock position, you will find the trash can, which will delete the marker or dot from your map and your map only. For markers that correspond with TAK app users or vehicles in motion, when deleted, they will reappear on your map when their location is next updated. Finally, within the wheel menu at the 10 o'clock position is the Fine Adjustment tool. Click the arrows, then click anywhere on the map. This will move the marker to that location. If you are trying to move an active dot, such as a TAK user or moving vehicle, the dot moves back the next time its location is updated to the TAK server. This tool is most useful when working with static shapes or markers. There are a few more important tools to cover, so let's return back to the launcher. If your launcher is no longer on your vertical toolbar, either drag the launcher back up or double-click the launcher icon, or click the plus button. Clicking on the Contacts tool will display a list of all TAK app users that are online. To message a user, tap the message box next to their name. Most importantly, you may also use the Contacts tool to locate other users. Clicking the contact icon next to their name will pan your map to their location and open the menu wheel. Next, we have Layers. At the top of the Layers tool, you will see your base map. This nomenclature is different from other TAK apps. Here, Layers refers to your base maps. Click on the map and you will see a few different options that you may use. Simply clicking on the desired map will change your WebTAK base map. To return back to the Tools page, create a new launcher page using the plus button in the upper left. You will likely notice that for many tools, there is no back arrow, so the best practice for now is to close your current window and reopen the launcher. This concludes our Getting Started tutorial on WebTAK, powered by the Colorado Department of Public Safety and the Center of Excellence for Advanced Technology Aerial Firefighting. Thanks for watching.